As the season rolls on, first-year quarterback Morgan Stens has a good grip on the offense.
And if they can capitalize on their potential, they'll bring the district title back home to Hillman once again.
On this difficult par 3, we're at one of the most common spots on this hole, the drop zone.
This isn't a baseball, it's a snowball. With the cold weather and the snow still lingering here at the Posen Baseball Diamond, it's forced the team to move their practice indoors. With just 3 road games remaining, the only way the Ice Diggers will see their home bench again is if they make the playoffs, something they've been talking about rather frequently.
Although last year was rough for the Wildcats, Tyler Skiba is slicing his way through the competition.
The Detroit Red Wings are in a bit of a slump. The boys with a winged wheel have lost 4 in a row coming into today's matchup with Alexander Ovechkin and the Washington Capitals. So they decided to make a couple lineup changes. Former Spartan Justin Abdelkader and Ville Leino in the lineup. And Leino getting his first NHL game experience. How would he respond to the pressure? Well, pretty well. In the first period, it's Leino in on the 2-on-1. And check out this play. It is a phenomenal move coming up the half spin, and the rookie scores between his legs with the back to the goal. 1-0 Detroit. A great start to a career by Leino. And what a way to make a National Hockey League debut. A beauty right there. But not to be outdone is the superstar Alexander the Great, game tied at 2 in the third period. And Ovechkin shuffles the puck between his legs, beating Ty Conklin low to the glove side, 3-2 Capitals. Take another look at that play by one of the league's finest talents. Then later in the period, off the faceoff, the Caps get the puck on net, and look who's camped out in front, waiting for the juicy rebound. That's Alexander Ovechkin, and he won't miss from there. 4-2 Caps, Ovechkin's 33rd goal of the season. The Capitals would go on to hand the Red Wings their 5th consecutive loss, 4-2. Next up for the Detroit is a home game with St. Louis on Monday night. On a rainy night last October, the Oscoda High football team played its final game of the season with the goal of breaking a 28-game losing streak. And with this miraculous run by Tom Schoenfeld, the Owls cruise to an emotional 40-12 victory.
Getting that and having those parents there to witness that and to see how much their kids had worked and to finally have that cemented for them was excellent.
It was awesome. Just not only the fact of us getting our first win, it's making history. It's just a really good feeling.
While last year's win at Rogers City could be looked at as a building block, only 5 players from that team will be wearing the blue and white this season.
We finished that game with 18 guys on the team at the varsity level, and 13 of them are seniors. So we've got 5 returners coming back, so as much as we'd like to use it as a springboard for a lot of them still weren't there to witness that and to feel that and to be a part of that.
While that upcoming season doesn't get underway until August 28th, Coach Davis has already found a way to add some motivation.
We've got the Lumberman's Cup trophy, which we'll play Hail for in our home opener this year. We've got the Veterans Memorial Trophy here. We'll play the Veterans Memorial Trophy will be against Alcona. And then finally, the Scottish Claymore Award. Those are our 3 additional trophies that we're playing for, again, to try and add significance to the games for the kids and get them motivated about them.
Motivation could come from many places for this Oscoda Owls program, but there is no doubt that one source will be looking back to that special October night in Rogers City. In Oscoda, Pat Titi, Channel 11 Sports. Jeff and Taylor Turner have mapped the line of travel through all 50 states, and today they reeled their lines in on the waters of Northeast Michigan.
Our plan is to try to fish 4 hours in every state, all 50 states, in 50 consecutive days. We started on June 13th on the Susquehanna River in Pennsylvania. We'll end on July 30th off the Kona Coast in Hawaii.
Upon the trip's conclusion, the duo will have traveled over 20,000 miles. Their 2 goals: to grow closer together and accomplish something memorable.
This is the last summer before he has a senior year in high school next year, and off to college after that. And I felt like if we were ever going to do something kind of exciting and adventurous, then this would be the summer to do it. So
I think I really want to be able to say that I did it. Like I don't want to say like I failed. I didn't get it done because we're like 34 days in. We got 16 days left.
These two have already waded the waters of 37 states. Today in Michigan, the Ausable River marks the 38th.
Michigan, I think, I'm not an avid fly fisherman. I only took it up a few years ago, but from the literature I've read, this is sort of the famed river of the region and has a lot of romance to it, it seems like, from all the things we've read. And so I think from anxious to fish this river has certainly been way up there for me.
Jeff and Taylor did have a successful day, although they didn't catch a trophy. 10 rainbow trout and 7 brown trout were the reward of their journey through Michigan. In Mile, Pat Tiede, Channel 11 Sports.